Hello, I'm Shiuni from MSK MRI.
I'll explore the three-layer approach to medial knee anatomy. This approach is crucial for understanding the complex relationship among the structures in this area. The green dashed line is layer 1, and the pink dotted line is layer 2. First up, we have layer 1, the deep crural fascia. This is the most superficial layer and is known as the deep crural fascia. It continues from the fascia of the sartorius muscle and moves posteriorly, while anteriorly, it fuses with the second layer to form what we know as the patellar retinaculum. I'll discuss two important aspects to be aware of in layer 1. First, let's talk about the layers of the patellar retinaculum. The medial patellar retinacular structures, also known as the medial patellofemoral ligament complex, are composed of the medial patellofemoral ligament, the medial quadriceps tendon femoral ligament, the medial patellomeniscal ligament, and the medial patellotibial ligament. The patellofemoral ligament and the medial patellotibial ligament were identified in layer 2. Both ligaments had adhesions with layer 1 in the region near the patella. The medial patellomeniscal ligament was identified in layer 3 and was intermingled with Hoffa's fat. In other words, to be precise, all three layers participate in the medial retinaculum. Secondly, let's examine the layers of the pes anserinus tendons. The pes anserine tendons are sartorius, gracilis tendon, and semitendinosus tendon. SM is the semimembranosus tendon. Layer 1 comprises the deep crural fascia, is continuous with the medial patellar retinaculum, and covers the sartorius muscle. The pes anserinus tendons, sartorius, gracilis, and semitendinosus, attach to the anteromedial aspect of the tibia. Beneath layer 1, the gracilis and semitendinosus tendons can be found. In essence, the pes tendons are located between layers 1 and 2. Moving on to layer 2, the superficial medial collateral ligament. Red is the superficial medial collateral ligament, aqua is the deep medial collateral ligament, and orange is the posterior oblique ligament. Superficial medial collateral ligament fuses posteriorly with layer 3, contributing to the formation of the posterior oblique ligament and the posteromedial capsule. These structures are key in providing additional support and stability to the knee. So, layers 1 and 2 are fused anteriorly and layers 2 and 3 are fused posteriorly. Lastly, we have layer 3, which includes the deep medial collateral ligament, along with the posterior oblique ligament and the oblique popliteal ligament. The deep medial collateral ligament is part of the joint capsule and can be distinguished from the superficial medial collateral ligament at the anterior border. At the posterior aspect, the deep medial collateral ligament bends with the superficial medial collateral ligament. Thank you for watching. If you found my video helpful, please remember to like it.